Hello students, I hope you all are fine and you all are also studying at your home. So students, today we are going to do the sixth science and the chapter number 3. And the name of the chapter is cleaning of food and the separation of substances. And this is my 4th video on this chapter. So students, in my last class, I have explained you these terms. Let us revise. So first of all, what is sediments? Sediments are the insoluble solid particles which settles down in water, right? So they are the insoluble solid particles that settles down in water. And what is the process of sedimentation? When the insoluble substance are settling down in water, that process of settling down the solid insoluble particles is called sedimentation. Now next is pouring, decantation. Then what is decantation? Pouring out liquid without disturbing the sediments is called decantation. After that, what is solute? A substance that we will add in the solvent is solute. For example, if we are making a sugar and salt water, then sugar and salt are the solute and water is the solvent. And what is the solvent? A liquid in which the solute will get dissolved is called solvent. And what is solution? Solution. Together, the solute and solvent mix together to form the solution, and solution is the transparent mixture of solute and solvent. Now students, our topic is separation of a soluble substance from an insoluble substance. So first of all, understand what are the soluble substances. Soluble substances are the substances that dissolves in water, that will completely dissolve and will form the clear solution. And what are the insoluble substances? They are the substances which will not dissolve in the solution. So let us understand. Add a spoonful of sugar to half full glass of water. Stir the solution. Sugar gets dissolved in water and disappears. Here we will take the spoon and we will take the water in the glass. And what we will do? We will add the sugar in the water and then we will stir it. Then what we'll see? Sugar will get disappear and sugar will get dissolved in the water. That means a substance which is soluble gets dissolved in water. What you have learned from here? The substance that gets dissolved in water, a substance which is soluble, that will get dissolved in water and forms the transparent solution. Now let us understand insoluble substance. So add a spoonful of powdered chalk to half glass of water and stir it. Now we have to take the powder of chalk and we will add it in the water and we will stir it. Now chalk forms milky suspension in water. Here the solution will not form. Here clear solution will not form. Actually here the suspension will form. A substance which is not soluble in water and it will not dissolve. Its particles remain separate. The particles of the chalk will remain separate in the water. And chalk particles remain suspended in water. They will be visible. Chalk particles will be clearly visible. Right? They will not mix together with the water. So, leave the suspension of chalk in water for some time. Now, after preparing the suspension, we will leave it for some time. Gradually, chalk particles settles down in water. Now, what will happen? The chalk particles will settle down in water because chalk is not soluble in water. Chalk is insoluble in water, right? Now, what are the another examples? Milk. Milk is the example of suspension. Milk is a suspension in which casein is the name of protein, fat and calcium particles remain suspended in water forming milky suspension. So, when we talk about the milk, so milk is what? In water, casein protein is present, fat is present and calcium particles are present together, right? So milk is the mixture, or milk is the suspension, right? Now what about the seawater? Seawater is also a mixture. Why? Because seawater is a solution of many salts in addition to many insoluble impurities which remain suspended in it. So in seawater solution, it is a solution of many salts. Many kind of salts are present in seawater. And it also contains insoluble impurities that are suspending in it. Now, let us understand miscible and immiscible liquids. Right? So, miscible liquids means when the liquids liquids. What I'm speaking, liquids. So when the liquids will mix together, mix with one another and go into the solution are called miscible liquids. For example, solution of glycerin and water. When you will add glycerin in water, you will see they will mix together completely. And such kind of liquids are called miscible liquids. And what are the immiscible liquids? Liquids which do not mix together. Liquids which do not mix with one another are called immiscible liquids. For example, if you will take water and in that water you will add some oil, then what you will observe? You will observe that they are not mixing. So when the liquids are not mixing together, then such kind of liquids are called immiscible liquid. Right? Actually, oil is not miscible with water. Oil does not mix with water to form a solution. Oil being lighter floats on water. So oil is lighter than water, so it will float on water and they will not mix together and oil will form immiscible liquid with the water. And water being heavier remains in a layer below the oil. So water is heavier than the oil, so it will remain below. And oil is separated from the water by the process of decantation and oil is poured out, leaving behind water. So how we will separate it? If we have the mixture of oil and water, then what will happen? Oil will form the layer on the upper side and water will be downside. So when I'll pour the mixture, then what will happen? The oil will come in another container and the water will remain in previous one container. So we have separated the miscible and immiscible liquids, right? Let us understand next process, that is loading, right? So what is loading? So loading is the process to expedite sedimentation, especially of fine particles of impurities such as dust particles which remain suspended in water for long. To remove these suspended dust particles, a crystal of alum is moved along the surface of muddy water. Now let us understand. Here we have the muddy water, right? In this muddy water there are the particles of impurities such as dust and all, right? So what we will do, we will add the alum in this water and this we will move the alum. Then what will happen here? Alum is soluble in water, so it will get soluble in water, and after dissolving in water, the particles of the alum will get attached with the clay or the dust particles that are present in this water. And after adding when this potash alum particles will add with the particles, then these muddy particles will become heavy. And when the particles of this will become heavy, then they will settle down fast. And what will happen? Then they will cause the sedimentation. See here. After that, they are the clay particles. Right? Now what we have seen here? Dust particles are here and this water is clean water. What is this? Clean water. Now what we will do? Clean water can be obtained now by the process of decantation. Again, we will obtain the clean water from here by the process of decantation. What we will do in decantation? We will pour this liquid, this water, in another container and only these impurities will leave behind. So students, let's check out our knowledge by looking some questions. Question number 1, name the process to separate the components from the following mixture. A part is oil from water. You have to tell the name of that process. Question number 2, how do we separate a component? Which A part is heavier than other, B part is larger than other, and C part floats and other things. So students, that's all about the today's class. I hope the content is clear to you. Very soon I'll come with the new content. Till then, all of you take care and bye bye. And thank you for the listening.